Bible says, riches do not profit in the day of wrath, but righteousness delivers from death. So you can quote John 3:16. Big deal. Big deal. You're still a sinner, though. It hasn't changed you. It hasn't helped you. You're still a sinner.
Sodomy is a sin.
I know it is. I know it is. Are you a sodomite? Are you a sodomite? Are you a sodomite? Sodomy is a sin. Riches will not profit you on judgment day, sinners, but the righteousness you need will profit you on judgment day. But so many of you are not righteous. You don't have any righteousness at all. And you prove it by your potty mouth. By your filthy mouth, you prove my point. Wow, you can put all your fingers down except for one? That's amazing. That takes a lot of skill and ability. Put all your fingers down on one hand except for one. You must have went to college for that. Must be a major in that kind of stuff. The riches won't profit you on judgment day. But righteousness can profit you. God will not judge you on judgment day by how much money you have. God will not judge you on judgment day by how big and how nice your car is. God's not going to judge you on judgment day by how designer your clothes are, how much money you spend on your clothes. But God will judge you by how you spend your money. God will judge you by how you live your life. God will judge you by every thought, word, and deed. The Bible says there is no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are naked and open to the eyes of him to whom must give an account. The sin you sinners flaunt in the open tells me you're a lot worse in private. You're in great danger. If you flaunt your sin like this in public, I wonder what you do in private. Even more filthy things. Yeah, I don't want to know. Filthy and disgusting, I'm sure. But people do these kind of things in public, it makes them even worse in private. But guess what? Nothing is private to God. Nothing is hidden from God. What did you say, sinner? Nothing's hidden from God's sight. You need Jesus Christ. You need to turn from your sins. You need to forsake your sins. You need to stop being drunkards. Look at all the beer bottles all over the place. You drunkards are filthy. You don't care about anybody but your filth. Well, you won't think I'm annoying and you go to hell. You'll know that I was the truth. You'll know I was the truth. You'll know what I'm saying is the truth on judgment day. But imagine in hell. Imagine this, sinners, if you die in your sins. Imagine in hell lifting up your eyes in torment and hearing my words over and over and over again. Over and over and over again. Hearing my words reverberate through your mind, reverberate through your conscience because you didn't repent. Because you didn't get right with God. Yes, you'll be reminded of this day if you don't repent. You'll be reminded of every time you heard the gospel. You'll be reminded of any gospel tract you were handed. You'll be reminded of every time you heard the truth. Every Bible you have on your bookshelf that collects dust, you'll remember it on judgment day. Because you had a chance to repent. You had an opportunity to repent, and you refused to repent. Wow, that's a good skill right there you got, Junker. You can put on all your fingers on one hand. Wow, except for one. What a great skill you have. Yes, drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of God. Look how many of you are stumbling in here. You can't even put a one sentence together that's slurring your speech. Shouldn't that tell you something? Shouldn't it tell you shouldn't be a drunkard? Your body's rejecting your drunkenness. Your body's rejecting your core is heavy, and your blood dumber, and your middle and low life. Your body rejects your drunkenness. The body that God created and made you, he rejects your drunkenness.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure you can.
Where in the Bible is it wrong to have a drink?
I said drunkards.
Where is it wrong in the Bible?
1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 and 10.
You're wrong.
Do you not know? Listen, you asked me a question, I'm answering it. Don't tell me I don't know, I'm quoting it for you. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 and 10. Do you not know the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God?
Do not be deceived.
Okay. Neither drunkards. Drunkards. Are you drunk?
Sir, no, I've had one drink.
Okay, well, are you planning to get drunk? Are you planning to get drunk?
No.
You're not planning to go in there and drink more?
No.
Mint juleps and Bud Dummer?
And we are fucking liars.
Yes, gambling's a sin too.
Look, I love the Christian faith.
There you go. If you love it, you obey God. You don't say, you wouldn't be going to this filthy place if you love God.
What is the original quote that you
have? Hello, quit talking to this racetrack.
The Greek text, sinner.
Yeah, you're wrong.
Yeah, you can say it wrong, but you have no proof for it. All you have is your love for your sin. All you have, you're a Christian. The Bible says, do not love the world or the things of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. That's you. You love the world. Adulterers and adulteresses. Do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Therefore, the friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. You're a friend of this world. You're an enemy of God. You're at enmity with God. God is not pleased with you if you're a friend of this world. The Bible says God is angry with the wicked every day. Angry. So all you drunkards out here today throwing your beer bottles and your beer cans all over the ground, guzzling your beer, slurring your speech, stumbling all over the place, you better watch out. You might stumble right into hell. You better watch out, drunkards. You might stumble right into the lake of fire. Yes, drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of God. Neither will those who have sex outside of marriage. There's lots of fornicators here today. Now you cheer for your own destruction, sinner. What a walking contradiction you are. You cheer for your own destruction. No wonder why your brain's all dirtied up with your marital life. Your brain's all dirtied up with your drugs and your alcohol. You can't even think straight. And you cheer on your own destruction. Anyone here to bet on horses? You're covetous, you're greedy, you need to repent. You're an idolater according to the Bible. The Bible calls covetous people idolaters. It says, for this you know, that no fornicator, unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God.
Want a beer, sir?
Yeah.
You're going to throw it out, aren't you?
I'm going to throw it out.
Have a good day.
Yeah. I'm going to dump it out. That's what I was going to do. Yeah. That's where it belongs. That poison belongs on the ground, not in your stomach. Not in your body, sinner. It belongs on the ground. I'm having lots of fun, sinner. I'm having lots of fun. I love preaching the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ. I love calling sinners to repentance. But life's not about fun, sinner. God didn't send a sinner down the cross so you can have fun. If your idea of fun is sinning, you're in big trouble. You have a skewed idea of fun. If your idea of fun is things that lead to your own destruction, your own demise, you have a weird idea of, a weird definition of fun. It's never fun to burn. And that's where sinners will, that's what happened to sinners. They're going to burn forever. Sinners will burn forever in the lake of fire. Malachi chapter 4 and verse 1 says this. It says, behold, the day is coming. Burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who do wickedly shall be stubble, and the day which is coming shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts. BYOB. Get your hand off my bullhorn. BYOB. I'm not shaking your hand. You're a sinner. No, you don't. You don't love Jesus. You got a beer in your hand. You don't love Jesus.
Oh, because I drink beer.
That's right, sinner. So you're a drunkard.
And you're a peasant.
Huh?
You're a peasant.
I'm like, what? Oh, because you're rich, you're better than me? Oh, no! Your riches are going to perish with you, sinner. They're going to perish with you. You can't take your riches with you to the grave. They're going to perish with you. Jesus Christ said, take heed and beware of covetousness. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of the things one possesses. Yeah, so many of you, your whole life revolves around things, possessions, money, riches. I don't get paid a penny. I don't get paid a penny to do this.
They're back there. That guy's coming up.
Okay. Yeah, so the Bible says, take heed and beware of covetousness. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of the things he possesses. So many of you, your life consists in things you buy, things you wear, things you own. It never consists in the Word of God and Jesus Christ dying for you and you living for him and being holy. How many people out here today can truly say their life consists in that? Well, not the drunkard with the mint julep in her hand. I don't think so. That's right, it is Christian-like. Yeah, my Jesus is going to judge the whole world, so it is Christ-like to judge. Yes, Christ's going to judge the whole world, so of course it's Christ-like to judge. But it's not Christ-like to judge like that and drink a mint julep, though, is it? To dress like a prostitute and drink a mint julep is not Christ-like.
Can I ask you a quick question? Go ahead. Give me one example when Jesus did what you're doing in the Bible. Give me one example.
The whole gospel according to Matthew. The whole gospel according to Matthew.
Quote it.
Give me one example of Jesus Christ going to church hill down and bedding on horses.
He actually took these people into his house and fed them.
No, he didn't. That would be no, he didn't have a house.
That would be the tax
collectors. Jesus Christ didn't have a house.
That would be the tax collectors. And he
I'm here with you. I'm here to create a repentance. I'm here to create a repentance.
Quote the gospel of Matthew for me.
They want me to quote.
You just said
the whole Sermon on the Mount, Matthew 5 through 7. Get your smartphone out and look it up. Matthew 5 through 7 is preaching to a multitude of people, warning them of hell, calling them to repentance.
What's your question?
I don't have to quote it.
You don't know scripture.
I do know
scripture.
Hey, smart. Go to the potty mouth.
You don't know.
Go to the potty mouth. The potty mouth is the middle of the Bible. The one who's gambling and horses tells me I didn't know about the Bible.
What about
trees? Don't hear the ripple and pick up all the Bible. You're a hypocrite! You're a hypocrite! Look it up for yourself, smartphone guy! Look it up for yourself! Matthew 5 through 7.
I don't want to buy him a Bible,
because
it doesn't...
Okay, here you go. Enter by... I got my Bible right here, sinner! Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction. There are many who go in by it. Oh, you're walking away now, aren't you? I'm giving you scripture, and you're walking away, sinner. I give you scripture, and you run away. No, I'm not. I'm a saint of God. I'm a saint of God. You're the one wearing the middle of real life hat. Yeah, I quote scripture and you run away. Keep running away, sinner. Keep running away. I just quote a scripture for you from Matthew 7. Keep running away. Christians don't get drunk. What's the thing with a drunk Christian? Jesus Christ commands you to repent. Jesus Christ commands you to go and sin no more. Not some more. Not try to stop sinning, but go and sin no more. The Bible says, the Lord Jesus Christ speaking, beware of the leaven of the Pharisees.
It's all good, bro.
Which is, you're not my bro. Beware of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. For there is nothing covered that will not be revealed. There's nothing hidden that will not be known. Yes, all you hypocrites here today who plan to go to a church building tomorrow, it will do you no good unless you repent. Unless you give up your sin completely. Unless you depart from iniquity. The Bible says the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal. The Lord knows who are His, and let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Yeah, so if you're going to name the name of Christ, you're going to call yourself a Christian, God's not a fool. He knows whether you're truly living for Him or not. You need to depart from iniquity. Give it up. Wow, that's a great skill you got there. You can put all your fingers on your hand except for one. Did you go to school for that? Yes. Didn't do it again, did you? Shame. Shame on you sinners who keep on sinning. Shame, shame, shame. Shame on you drunkards. Shame on you potty mouths. Shame on you fornicators. Shame on you blasphemers. Shame on you covetous, greedy, horse race bettors. Shame on you immodestly dressed women. Shame on you sinners. You need to follow Jesus Christ. You need to stop being a sinner. You need to go and sin no more. Jesus Christ said, repent or perish. That's not modest. Not even close. Not even close. Not even close. Put more clothing on. Put looser clothing on. Repent or perish, Jesus Christ said. One way of saying that is turn or burn. The way of saying that is to fly or fly. Consecration or condemnation. Deliverance or damnation. Those are your only options. Those are your only choices. You need to follow Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ won't lead you into Churchill Downs to bet on horses. Jesus Christ won't lead you to dress immodestly. Jesus Christ won't lead you to get drunk. Jesus Christ won't lead you to lust. Jesus Christ won't lead you to be covetous idolaters. Jesus Christ won't lead you to be a Muslim or a Roman Catholic. Jesus Christ will lead you in righteousness. If you're here today, the bet on horse races, you are unrighteous. And the judgment and wrath of God. No, no, no. God doesn't say you can't judge. Well, you know why you're saying that? Because you're a sinner. And you don't want to be judged yourself. That's why you're saying that. Because you're a sinner. And you know you're condemned. You know you're in trouble. So you don't like judging. But if you were clean before God, you wouldn't mind judging. If you were clean before God, judgment wouldn't bother you. The reason judgment bothers people, it's the reason why people have this mantra, thou shalt not judge, don't judge me, God said you can't judge, is because they're sinners under God's judgment. Just like a criminal is like hanging out with cops. You ever see a criminal as a hangout with cops, the good cops who aren't corrupt? Of course not. You don't see criminals hanging around the courthouse or the police station. That's why sinners don't like judging. But guess what? Judgment day is coming. God's going to judge your life, and you're going to be in big trouble if you don't repent. You're going to be in big trouble if you don't repent. Your only chance to get right with God is right now. You're not even guaranteed to make it through the night, especially you drunkards who go home driving drunk. You're not guaranteed to make it through this night. I saw a young lady here yesterday about to die on this grass because he was so drunk. You drunkards are destroying your brain, destroying your liver, destroying your kidney. You're destroying your body. That's why your body throws up your liquor. That's why your body throws up your alcohol. Your body's rejecting your alcohol. Stop being a drunkard. Drunkenness leads to hell. You destroy your body and then you destroy your soul in hell through your drunkenness. The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 6, with food and clothing, with these things we shall be content. But those who desire to be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and drown themselves in many foolish and harmful lusts.
Can I get a picture with you?
If you take a gospel track.
What?
If you take a gospel track, you can.
Can I take a gospel track?
Yes, one of these right here. You take this and you read it, I want you to take a picture. Are you going to read it?
Yeah.
Okay, you can take a picture.
All
right. Nothing weird, though.
No, nothing weird. Just a selfie. It's going on Instagram. All right, thanks, man.
Yep, no problem. Yeah, so the Bible says if you desire to be rich, and that's most of you here, let's be honest. Most of you here because you want to be rich or you already are rich. The Bible says if you desire to be rich, you fall into temptation and a snare and drown yourself in many foolish and harmful lusts. The Lord Jesus Christ said you cannot serve two masters. You're going to hate the one and love the other, also be loyal to the one and despise the other. You can't serve God in riches. You can't serve God in your sin. You need to be loyal to God, completely surrendered to God. Who are you talking to, sinner? Pull up your pants, man. Get a belt. And you know how to dress. Pull up your pants and get a belt. Learn to respect people who are older than you and follow Jesus Christ. Find your way to destruction, sinner. Follow Jesus Christ. You cheer for your destruction? Yeah. You won't be cheering, really pumping your fist in hell. No fist pumping in hell for sinners. Or we're going, and hell. Yes, you'll be in torment. You'll be weeping and gnashing your teeth, the Bible says. Be weeping and gnashing. You know, if you could hear the sinners who are in torment right now crying out, you would know what awaits you. You would know what awaits you. The Bible says, fear God and keep his commandments, for this is man's all. For God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. God's going to bring all your sin into judgment, all your secret sin, all your porn watching, all your greed, all your selfishness, all your hatred, all your bitterness, all your gossip, God's going to bring it into judgment. No, I'm heterosexual, sinner. Heterosexual. Yes, God's going to bring it all into judgment. The thoughts of your life. Think about just your thoughts from this last day, how wicked and depraved they are. How many times you've lusted after a woman or a man today? How many times today you've been covetous? How many times that you wanted to say something wicked but didn't say it? God's going to bring your thoughts into judgment. Do you realize how much you should tremble before God because of that one fact? That God's going to bring your thoughts into judgment? The Bible says, by your words you'll be justified, and by your words you shall be condemned. So many people today, their words condemn them. They take God's name in vain like it's no big deal. They have four-letter filth words pour out of their mouth like it's no big deal. The sin that pours out of your mouth like the water over Niagara Falls. It reveals the state of your heart. And yes, filthy words come out of your mouth, it shows you a filthy heart, need of cleansing. Christ can cleanse you. Christ can change you. The Bible says, wash yourselves, make yourselves clean. Put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do good. Come now, and let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as wool, if you are willing and obedient. Christ is willing to wipe away the stain of your sin, the filth of your sin, the disgust of your sin. Christ is willing to wash it away by his shed blood. But you have to repent. Don't fall over. Don't fall over, drunkard. I don't want you to hurt yourself. I don't want you to end up in hell either. Forsake your drunkenness. Be sober. Follow Jesus. I'm not a sodomite. You may be a sodomite, but I'm not a sodomite. I'm heterosexual. I'm married. Yeah, I'm married, sinner. You're filthy. You're filthy. You're perverted. You're probably into pornography, aren't you? You're probably a porn watcher, aren't you? I can tell by the filth that pours out of your mouth so easily, you're probably a porn watcher. Yes, you need Jesus Christ to cleanse you. Christ to make you a new creature. Do you watch porn at your job? You need to repent of your job. Get a new job. Your job's leading you to hell. Jesus Christ can save you. Jesus Christ can save you and change you. The Bible says, anyone is in Christ, he's a new creature. All the old things have passed away. Behold, all has become new. Christ can make you new. Christ can change you. Christ can deliver you. The Bible says that godly sorrow leads to repentance, to salvation, not to be regretted, but the sorrow of the world leads to death. Godly sorrow is when you see your sin and see you shouldn't be doing it, and you are broken before God because you know you sinned against God, you know you deserve hell, and you become broken over your sin and weep over your sin and mourn over your sin and fling yourself upon the mercy and grace of God. That's your only hope. That's your only hope. The Bible says, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning, your joy to gloom. Humble yourself in the sight of God, and he will lift you up. God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. You need to humble yourself. Stop being so prideful. Stop being so puffed up. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before the fall. You're on your way to a fall. You're on your way to destruction because you're pride, because you're puffed up. You think you're so special. Well, you're a speck of dust in the face of this planet, and the universe is so huge, and God created it all, and you think you shake your fist in God's face and have no consequences for your actions? You're in trouble. You're going to follow Jesus Christ. Stop being a sinner. God will condemn sinners to hell for all eternity if they don't repent. The Bible says, keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. If you continue to live wicked, God's face is against you, set against you. He said, cut off the remembrance of you from the earth. And if you're righteous, his eyes are on you, his eyes of protection, his eyes of love are upon you, and his ears are open to your cries. But the Bible says, depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. That's what you need to do. Depart from evil and do good. Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. You do need Jesus. We all need Jesus. Jesus Christ said, do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming, and it's all who are in the grave. Shake your head all you want, sinner. And it's all who are in the graves shall hear his voice and come forth. Those who have done good, to the resurrection of life. Those who have done evil, to the resurrection of condemnation. Which resurrection will you take part in? The resurrection of life or the resurrection of condemnation? Listen to the words of Jesus Christ again. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming, and which all who are in the grave shall hear his voice and come forth. Those who have done good to the resurrection of life, those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation. Jesus Christ said in Matthew 13, the Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all things that offend, and those who practice lawlessness, and will cast them into the furnace of fire. There'll be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. He who has ears, let him hear. As only righteous will shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. The Bible says, in this, the children of God and the children of the devil are manifest. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God.
Shut the fuck
God bless
up.
You, drunkard.
Huh?
God bless you, drunkard. Go to heaven.
Yeah.
Go to heaven, man.
Don't you shut the fuck
Go to the
up.
Kingdom of
You're
God. I know your mouth. I know your filthy mouth. I know your drunkenness. I know your cigar smoking. I know you're here with it. You're probably a fornicator too, aren't you? Yeah, I know you enough. I don't know, just by seeing you for 30 seconds, I know enough about you to know you're on your way to destruction.
Judgment isn't what God judges.
Why are you judging me then?
Yeah, I'm just telling you not to judge me.
You just judged my judgment. You judged my judgment by saying God doesn't want judgment. That's judging. Yeah, see your filthy mouth, and you're drinking your mouth, you're drinking your hand, and your middle finger sticking up tells me you're not a Christian. No, sinner. God bless you. I hope you go to the kingdom of God. I hope you don't repent. I hope you repent. I hope you don't go to hell. I hope you give up your filthy mouth and your drunkenness and your fornication. I hope you get right with God before it's too late for you. I hope you get right with God before it's too late for you. Follow Jesus Christ. Stop dressing like harlots who belong on street corners. Follow Jesus Christ. Stop being drunkards and potty mouths. Stop being pot smokers and liars and thieves. Stop being greedy, covetous horse bettors. Stop being people who desire to be rich. Follow Jesus Christ. Now, Jesus Christ had nowhere to lay his head. Didn't even own a house. The Lord of all the earth, when he was on earth for 33 years, didn't even own a house. And you people want to own mansions and $100,000 cars and $500 tickets to a horse race that lasts 2 minutes. Give me a break. Let's have the worst rate of a purchase ever in history. $500 for 2 minutes. That's horrible. That's horrible. That's $1,500 an hour they're making off of you. No, $15,000 an hour, excuse me, they're making off of you. What's that? $500 ticket, 2 minute horse race, multiply 500 times 30, that's $15,000 an hour that Churchill Downs is making off of the people who come in here and buy a $500 ticket. What a waste of your money. What a waste of your time.
It's all day, it's not 2 minutes.
What's that?
It's all day, it's not 2 minutes.
Well, the horse race is 2 minutes. That's what brings you here. You wouldn't be here if it wasn't a horse race, sir. The horse race lasts 2 minutes. Oh, the Kentucky Derby is what everyone comes here for. Everyone comes here for a derby, not for a horse race before that. Right? If it wasn't a derby, they wouldn't be here. Yeah. This place makes $100 million off of you people. $100 million. 120,000 seat capacity. $500 per ticket, $60 million off of one race. What a bunch of nonsense, man. What a bunch of foolishness. What a waste of your time. What a waste of your money. What a waste of your life to be at a horse race that lasts 2 minutes. All this money you spend, all the drunkenness you pour into your body, all the lust you're getting through your eyes.
Why are you mad?
I'm mad because you're on your way to hell. That's why I'm mad. I don't want you to go to hell.
I'm on the fast track.
To hell?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't want you to be, sir. I want you to be right with God. Get right with God while you still have time.
I think he's a liar.
No, he's not a liar. I think he's telling me the truth. He may be a liar, too, but what he just said was the truth. A liar doesn't mean you're always lying, but what he just said was the truth. Can I help you? No, that's the right message. Right place, right time, right message. Follow Jesus. Stop being sinner. You ain't giving account for those words, sinner. Okay. You're giving account for those words. Every idle word you'll give an account of on judgment day. Every idle word, sinner. I hope you repent. I hope you seek the forgiveness and mercy of God. Wow, you can put your middle fingers up? Wow, that's amazing. It's amazing. People think it's so amazing to put their middle fingers up with all their fingers down. So what? Don't hurt my feelings. Not going to change the message. Not going to change the fact that you're on your way to hell if you're a sinner. Yes, you need Jesus more than you know. In the fall. No, Jesus didn't have beer. Jesus hates your beer. Jesus hates your drunkenness. Jesus hates what you do to your body. I mean, look at it. You barely can even stand up. You really? I'm talking to her. You barely even stand up. God doesn't want you to be that way. Do you really think God made you in his image so you can do it to yourself? You're under the illusion, young man. You don't really think that. You're deluded. You're deceived. Follow Jesus Christ. Stop being a sinner. Drunkenness leads to hell. Well, stop being a drunkard then. Put down your Bud Dumber. Pour it out. Yeah, I knew you wouldn't pour it out. It's your idol. Look, just go ahead and bow down to it. It's your idol. Go ahead. Go ahead and bow down to it. I know it's your idol. You worship it. You'll be worshiping the porcelain God later on tonight when you get drunk and throw it all back up.
Excuse me.
You're excused. You need Jesus Christ. She didn't. First of all, the Bible there says Mary Magdalene was a whore. Secondly, if she was, she didn't keep on being a whore. She followed Jesus Christ. If you're following Jesus Christ, you're not going to be a sinner. Because Jesus Christ won't lead you to sin. For sinning, you're not following Jesus Christ. If you're going to be in a horse races, you're not following Jesus. If you're dressed like a harlot, you're not following Jesus Christ. If you're out here, you're applying it to yourself, aren't you? See, your conscience is bothering you. If you have to keep pulling your skirt down, it's a sure sign you don't have enough clothes on. And if you keep on pulling your dress up, it's a sure sign you don't have enough clothes on. Clothing's meant to cover. Cover yourself up. Dress properly in public. Didn't your parents teach you better than that? Hey, keep on pulling your dress up, but keep pulling it down. It's a sure sign you're not having the clothing. Well, see? It's convicting you, isn't it? It's bothering you. Because you know you're not dressed properly. You know it. Otherwise, you just walk on by. You just stick the middle finger up to me. You'd walk on by if you didn't apply it to yourself. The clothing's meant to cover. clothing's meant to cover. You know who invented these kind of clothings? And like bikinis and these tight mini skirts? You know who invented them? The devil invented them. What kind of clothing would the devil invent? Clothing that's tight as possible, as small as possible, and as colorful as possible. That's the kind of clothing the devil is in the job and the business of inventing. And much of those who sit here today, you walk around with devil's clothing on. Clothing that's as colorful as possible to attract the eye, as short as possible to reveal as much, and as tight as possible to reveal what is not being revealed. You dress in the devil's clothing. Well, God commands you to repent and put on proper clothing. Clothing that covers your body. Clothing that's not as tight as the layer of skin. That's what God commands you to do. Jesus Christ can save even the immodestly dressed woman. He can save you. But if he saves you, he will change you. When Christ saves someone, he changes someone. He transforms someone from the inside out. So the things that God hates, you hate. The things that God loves, you love. You know, the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 9 about Jesus Christ that he loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. Jesus Christ loves righteousness and hates lawlessness. Jesus Christ loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. But the fact of the matter is, most of you who are here today, you engage in the very things day in and day out that God hates, that Jesus Christ hates. And you despise the things that God loves.
What does God love?
Put your hands off of me.
What does God love?
He loves righteousness and he hates lawlessness.
Woo! Righteousness!
Are you a sinner?
I'm a sinner. No. Everybody's a sinner. You're
no.
a sinner.
No, I'm a saint of God.
You're not a sinner. You've never sinned in your life?
No, I've sinned in the past, but I've repented of it.
Oh, okay.
I've
so that
it.
Doesn't make you a sinner because you were a sinner in the past, but doesn't count.
I'm a former sinner.
Okay.
Yeah.
Everybody has deal with the
Bible. Well, that's what you want to think because it makes you feel justified in your own wickedness.
God will forgive me when I die.
No, he won't. No, he won't.
The Bible tells me.
No, the Bible never says that. Give me a Bible. Just give your smartphone out and show me that Bible verse in the Bible. You won't do it. The Bible does not say God will forgive you when you die. Your chance, your only hope for forgiveness is right now. Right now is your only chance, your only hope for forgiveness. And there are conditions to God's forgiveness. You must stop it. You must give it up. You must follow Jesus Christ to be forgiven by Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is not a fool. He will not forgive those who keep on sinning. We will not forgive those who keep on looking at pornography and keep getting drunk and keep lying and stealing and coveting. Oh, you do some of those things, don't you? Huh? You do some of those things, don't you?
What?
You do some of those things, don't you?
Do some what things?
I just named off.
I didn't hear them.
And why'd you stop all of a sudden?
Oh, I don't know, because you're looking goofy. What are you doing?
Are you here getting drunk? You sound like you're drunk. No. You're slurring your speech together.
I'm slurring my speech together? What are you doing?
I'm preaching. Preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ.
I remember my first fart.
You know, the Bible says drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of God. There, right? You're going to end up in hell if you don't repent, sir. Young man, you're going to end up in hell if you don't repent. Repent today while you still have time. Follow Jesus Christ. Don't be a sinner. Don't be covetous. Don't be greedy. Don't dress like prostitutes. Follow Jesus Christ. Follow Jesus Christ. He can save you. He can change you. He can deliver you from all of your sins. From all of your sinning, Christ can deliver you. You know, I think...
Hey, Kerrigan, Daryl LaValle, I hate to interrupt you, but I ordered these tracks from you, man.
Oh, praise the Lord.
About 5,000.
Praise
okay.
the Lord.
And Josh back there said, you're the guy at Pinpoint, it's your business.
Gospel tracks, yeah.
Yeah, okay, man.
Praise
all
right, the Lord.
All right,
Daryl, God bless you.
You know, I think that these shirts you see being sold at the Derby can tell you a lot about the Derby. And look at that shirt right there. I got effed up at the Derby. Now, what does that tell you about that man and his knowledge of the Derby? He knows that most of you people who come here to get drunk. That's what it tells you. And he's going to sell Derby a lot of those shirts today because you revel in your drunkenness. You revel in it. People sell these shirts at the dinner because they know they have clientele here. They know they have customers who buy these shirts because they can say about themselves what the shirt says about them. But they get drunk at the derby. You know, if you really want to be a drunkard, there's lots of cheaper ways to get drunk. Go home and get a case of beer. But I wouldn't even recommend that, obviously, because drunkenness, whether at Churchill Downs or at your house, still leads to hellfire. Really, they should rename it Church Hell Downs. Change the I into an E. Church Hell Downs. Because most of the people who go in here, 99.9% of people who go in here, they're going down to hell and they're going to church.
It's so much fun
going to hell?
Yep.
Well, get your lighter out and light yourself on fire right now, Vincent.
I'm about to light something on fire.
You won't do it. You're a vocal hypocrite. You don't want to go to hell.
Hypocrite.
You don't want to go to hell. You won't light yourself on fire because you know you won't enjoy it. Exactly. You're going to hell and you'll be on fire forever. Oh, it's I enjoy it. I enjoy burning forever. So, okay, whatever you say. But if you're here today and you're going to go to church tomorrow, you're on your way down to hell. If you're here today tomorrow to sin and you're going to church tomorrow, you're on your way down to hell at Church Hell Downs. You know, follow Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ wouldn't lead you to wear that kind of clothing. Jesus Christ wouldn't lead you to go to Church Hell Downs. Jesus Christ wouldn't lead you to be a sinner today and then go to church tomorrow and get right with God. All of you Roman Catholics here today, I want you to know one thing. If you go confessing to your priest tomorrow, it's not going to help you one bit. You're going to confess your sins to the great high priest, Jesus Christ. Not to these pedophile, child-molesting priests who are wicked on the way to hell themselves. You're going to confess your sins to the great high priest, Jesus Christ, who never has sinned and never will sin. Completely holy, completely perfect. The Lord Jesus Christ, who died for you. He'll never sin against anybody. And yet, even though Jesus Christ will never sin against anyone, he has a day called Judgment Day. Now, what does that tell you about all you sinners who hate being judged, who hate the word judge? It tells you that you don't know what you're talking about. Because Christ Jesus, the Lord Jesus, is going to judge you on Judgment Day for your sins. And Jesus Christ is not a sinner. Therefore, judging is not a sin. Judging is righteous as long as done righteously. Jesus Christ said, when you judge, judge with righteous judgment and not according to appearance. In 1 Corinthians 2:15, the Bible says, a spiritual man judges all things, but he himself is rightly judged by no man. Yes, Judgment Day is coming. And on that day, the saints will be vindicated, the saints of God, the Christians will be vindicated by God as holy and righteous and pure. And the Bible says that God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away.
You want a beer?
No, sinner. The answer to your problem is not beer. Answer your problem is repentance. Stop being a sinner. That's the answer to your problems. That's part of the problem. You sinners, and the answer to your problems, your stress, all your problems in life, let's go gargle down some beer and get drunk. Not the answer to your problem. That just compounds your problems. Getting drunk compounds your problems. And makes your situation worse than it was in the beginning. Puking your guts out, waking up places you don't know how you got there, getting a DWI and getting your license taken away, killing someone through driving drunk and manslaughtering them. Drunkenness never leads to good. Your drunkenness has never done you any good. Your sin has never done you any good. That's amazing. A drunkard can still put one finger up his hand and only that finger. That's amazing. That's amazing. Must not be too drunk yet. You're in about a couple of hours, you don't do that anymore though, right? Yeah. Tells you a lot about your body, that God created a lot about drunkenness. You shouldn't be doing it.
It's all about anal sex.
Yeah, sodomy is a sin too, sinner. Sodomy is a sin too.
It feels really good.
It won't feel good in hell, sinner. You regret your sodomy then. You regret your sodomy in hell. You regret your porn watching in hell. You regret your drunkenness in hell. You regret your filthy mouth in hell. And you know what? You ought to live in light of the fact that hell is real. You ought to live in light of the fact that God's going to send sinners to hell. You ought to live in the fear of God. You ought to live in the fear of God. The Bible says the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of God is the fountain of life. To turn one away from the snares of death. Yes, God, you know, you need more fear in your life. More fear of God. You need more hatred in your life. More hatred of sin.
One, two, three.
The only person who's going to get eternal life is that person who fears God and keeps his commandments. Do you fear God? Do you love God? Jesus Christ said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. And Jesus said, are you a friend of God or an enemy of God? Jesus Christ said, a friend of God. In John 15, 14, Jesus Christ said, you are my friends, and you do whatever I command you to do.
Someone help me, I can't breathe.
You are my friends, and you do whatever I command you to do. And what Jesus Christ said, if you are a friend of Jesus Christ, you're doing whatever he commands you to do. In John 14 and verse 21, Jesus Christ said, he who has my commandments and keeps them, it is he who loves me, and he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. If you really love Jesus Christ, you'll obey Jesus Christ. If you really love Jesus Christ, you'll keep his commandments. If you don't keep his commandments, it's obvious to Jesus Christ and those around you that you really don't love Jesus Christ. Because if you really love Jesus Christ, you stop being a sinner. You stop being a drunkard. You stop being a potty mouth. You stop being a thief. You stop being covetous. You follow Jesus Christ. If you love Jesus Christ, you stop dressing like a harlot. If you love Jesus Christ, you stop betting on horses. If you love Jesus Christ, you stop idolizing the things that Jesus Christ created, like horses. The Bible says in Romans chapter 1 that people worshiped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. And so many of you have so many idols, so many things you worship, so many things you bow down to, but you won't bow down to the one who deserves you bowing down to him. You won't bow down to the one who deserves you to bow down to him. You need to follow Jesus Christ. You need to stop your sinning and follow him. He's the only way. He's the only truth. He's the only life. His name is the Lord Jesus Christ.